Life is 10% what happens to you and 90% of how you react to it. Charles Swindoll. How happy we are often depends on our perceptions and what we choose to focus on. When times are tough, it's easy to think the worst and focus on the negative. However, during these times, this is when it's most important to seek out the positives and focus on them. This is not to say that we ignore the struggles that surround us and just pretend they do not exist. They do exist, and we must acknowledge them. The term positive toxicity refers to the excessive and ineffective overgeneralization of a happy, optimistic state across all situations. This results in the denial, minimization, and invalidation of the authentic human emotional experience. That is not the goal. What we want is to become a rational optimist. Sean Aker defines this as having a realistic assessment of the present while maintaining a belief that our behavior will eventually create a better reality. It is about acknowledging the struggles and being empowered to know that we have the ability to work towards a better situation. Often when we explain the difference between optimism and pessimism, we use the idiom, is the glass half full or half empty? The truth is that optimism is more than just seeing the glass as half full. A rational optimist in this situation understands that the glass is refillable. This is a powerful view to have when experiencing tough times. It gives us hope that with time and effort, things will get better. Another key aspect of becoming more optimistic is to understand when you are being pessimistic. In the book Learned Optimism, Martin Seligman says that how we choose to explain situations to ourselves indicates if we're being optimistic or pessimistic. He encourages us to look at the three P's of pessimism: personalization, permanence, and pervasiveness. Personalization is determining who's at fault. A pessimist will often determine that they are to blame, even if they're not to. It's important that we learn to look at the facts and only own what we are responsible for. Permanence refers to how long we feel the event will last. A pessimist will often feel that the situation will never be resolved, whereas an optimist sees the situation as temporary. The key is to remember that situations always pass and new opportunities emerge. Pervasiveness is letting negative situations affect other areas of your life. Optimists are better at compartmentalizing their negatives, whereas a pessimist will allow these negatives to transfer into different areas. If we want to be more positive, we need to learn not to let the negatives in one aspect of our lives taint the aspects of our lives that are going well. Through reflecting on how we explain situations to ourselves, we learn how we approach and deal with adversity in our lives. As educators, we know that throughout our careers we will be met with challenging situations. Whether that be a tougher class, angry parents, or conflicts on staff, taking a rational optimist approach will give us the best opportunity to get through the situation with a positive attitude and a love of teaching still intact. When you are struggling, take time to write down the facts as objectively as possible. Then analyze how you're explaining the situation to yourself and if there are other explanations possible. From there, find the light at the end of the tunnel to focus on and take the first step towards getting through this situation and into a better place. Believe that over time you will arrive in that better place. Just keep moving forward. You can do it. As you learn more about rational optimism, share it with your staff and students. We can all benefit from learning to see the world through a more optimistic lens. Thank you for joining us, and remember to strive for happiness in education. You deserve it.